Good morning from Narok House. Today is going to be a different type of video. We're going to be answering some of the questions that we've gotten from our fans. So moving on to the first question, who inspired our journey to homesteading? At the beginning, it was about just getting out of the city. We were just tired of everything, the noise, the pollution, the stress that is so much in the city. So we decided to look for somewhere that is less with all that stress, and became here. Also, during that time before we moved, we started watching a lot of off-grid channels on YouTube. So that really, really influenced us, and we saw that it could be possible with what we had, and we decided to choose this path. The second question is, what was your inspiration to build a home in such a place? We really love to interact with nature, as I've said before. So in this place, there's a lot of animals, there's a lot of trees, there's a lot of freedom to just explore. Also for our animals, our dogs, our cats, they just love to have this open space to do whatever they want. And then the second thing is we just didn't like neighbors. We liked our privacy. So we decided to look for a place that was not overpopulated and would not be overpopulated for some years to come. So we decided to come to this place that the population is so minimal, and we have our privacy to do with whatever we want. The most popular question is get is, are we ever going to get a house tour anytime soon? People have really insisted on a house tour. Anyway, the house tour is coming very soon. Just be patient. It will come, and it will come with a bang. We just need to finish a few things inside the house, so when you see it, you'll appreciate our work of art. So someone asks, how do you spend our free time when you're not creating content? So when you live in a homestead, there's a lot of work to be done. So we usually have the animals to take care of. Like the chickens, you have to wake up in the morning to feed them. We have to give them water. We have to feed our cat, who is inside here, right? Now, just doing her things. And then we also have to feed the dogs. We have to give them food. We have to also water our plants. There's a lot of upkeep also that you need to be done in the homestead that you don't really film. There's a lot of nitty-gritties that really need to be done. So if you've lived in a farm, you know all of these things that need to be done inside a homestead. So there's a lot of stuff we never had, just sit down and relax. But also there's also time for just sitting down and chilling and enjoying what we've created here. Someone also asked what type of wild animals we've encountered. There are so many wild animals over here, so many. For example, we've seen zebra, antelopes, giraffes. There's so many giraffes over here. There are also hyenas and leopards, serval cats also, and also wild dogs. People always wonder, are we never afraid of these animals? When we came here, we were very, very much afraid. Oh, yeah, and there are also snakes, a lot of snakes that we've seen, and those are the monstrous things. So we've encountered so many of them, and we are always asked, are we afraid of these animals? When we came here, we were so much afraid of them, but we learned to live with them. We learned to live with among nature. Sometimes we cross paths, and sometimes it doesn't go well. Like a few months back, our dog was taken by a leopard, and it was a very sad experience, but once you enter into their territory, you know you're going to disturb them. So at some point, you'll cross paths. Sometimes it will be a good experience, sometimes bad, but you just move on with life. Yeah, and then giraffes, we see them, we walk with them, they don't have an issue. All the other animals, they're not bad, apart from snakes that we see so many times. Sometimes they're there, sometimes they're not there. There's snake season, there's no snake season. So when there's snakes around, our cats usually helps to keep the away. Our cat and the dogs, they sound alarm, and most of the time the snakes just disappear. So someone also asked, how do you get rid of snakes permanently? That's a very, very hard question, because in the savannah, you cannot get rid of something completely because we are in their territory. So the best you can do is just try and keep them away from our chicken and the best way that we do that is getting our cat to help us do that. She patrols and scares them away. Speaking of our cat, her name is Suki. Someone also asked how old she is. She's 3 years old. She's a very, very, very mischievous cat, but we'll love her like that. So someone also asked, why haven't you dug a borehole to supplement our water supply during dry season when there's no rain? That's because digging a borehole is so much money, for sure. And right now, we're not aiming to start taking loans and to do some other things. So for now, we work with trucking our water in when there's no rain. Like right now, there's been a very long dry spell, so we truck in our water. But at the end of the day, we plan to dig a borehole. And thanks to you all, at least, we're seeing that we're going to get there. So keep watching. Please subscribe if you haven't subscribed. Share widely and grow with us on this journey. So the most popular question we get asked is, how much is land over here? And could we connect someone to get land next to us and be our neighbor? Sadly, is we moved over here, sadly we do not have neighbors, so I don't think we'd want to have neighbors over here. Also, we bought the land so many years ago, so the land prices over here that have skyrocketed, so we don't know exactly how much it is. So, but if you want land in Kajiado, there's so much land in Kajiado, do your due diligence and get something that you will enjoy for the rest of your life. Most of you have been wondering, was I a professional chef in my previous life or before we moved here? Not really. I've never been a professional chef ever. It's just that I love to eat good food. I love really, really good food. My husband also likes really good food. And growing up, my mom also loved to cook for us very nice food. So I grew up eating and learning how to cook all these delicacies that we've been cooking here. And also the social media nowadays just helps. So every time I look for something to cook, I get recipes and I turn them around. I add a little touch of Narok House and then voila, we get the meals that we deliver to you guys. But cooking is not really bad. It's not hard to cook. So if you just put some little work into it, you get a very good meal, a very simple but very, very appetizing meal. Someone asked, relocation to the village comes with challenge. What was your biggest challenge? The biggest challenge when we moved here 3 years ago was that convenience of going to the shop any other time that we needed something. 3 years later, we've learned to live without the convenience of the city. For example, instead of calling someone to order a pizza or something, we just wake up, make the dough, and make our own pizza. And trust me, you learn so many things when you don't have the convenience of the city. Someone asked, do you miss the city? At the beginning, we used to miss the convenience of it, but right now, we actually dread going to the city because we're used to the quiet and the slow life living over here. So we don't really miss that life that much. We go once in a while, do our bar, do eat out, have a little fun, but right now it's not on our mind as much. So someone else asked, do you have any intention of holding paid workshops on your property about off-grid living? we used to do the workshops earlier on our journey, like a year ago. But as of now, we have so many projects going on. So we'd rather get them going. And when we have maybe minimal works going on, that's when we'll maybe consider going back to doing workshops, because most of our fans want to know how we actually live and also try and start on their own journey. So it's something that we're actually considering. Would you consider in the future listing your home as an Airbnb and relocate to the city? That's a definite hell no. The amount of effort, blood, sweat and tears that we've put into our home is a lot. So as of now, I don't think we'd want to leave our piece of heaven and move to the hustle and bustle of the city. We are definitely grounded over here. Another question that we get a lot is, do you have children? And how many children do you have? So we have only one child. He's just finishing secondary school, so that tells you how old we are. Very old. Yeah, and he is trying to adapt to off-grid life, although he bounces from us to his grandparents, because grandparents are still living in the city and not so in the wild. So we try and get him both of both worlds so that he can experience the off-grid life and the city life. This one disturbs a lot of people. So we've been asked a lot of time, why is the Mr.'s face never shown on our channel? That man, he's too sexy to handle, so let me just keep him to myself. In the meantime, like, subscribe and share to keep this channel going. Thank you so much for giving us the love, and see you on the next one. Bye.